I'm Cemal Bulunmaz, and that's Ringmaker. Today we will have a look how to use background tools on bangles and rings. So let's see what's inside this machine. We have many different background tools. They are all applied for different applications. For example, you may have a small wedding band, a tiny one. Then you must use such small one. Or you can have a huge bangle or another big ornament. You can choose like big ones. We offer up to 300 different models of background tools, but I can say that you will need 5 or 10 different tools when you use with your machine. I will start with this mini head tool. That's our smallest, tiniest tool. It's designed for wedding bands. So let's see how the effect will be. Was our tiniest tool. It's a T1, we call it. Means there is a one cutter only, and the head size is like kind of 3 millimeters, which is our minimum size. So I will have a wow, that was hard, huh? It's not easy to get out your rings, never forget. So that's the result that you will get that with that mini tool. So mostly we use it on wedding bands. You can still use on your bangles. It was a nice tool. When you are using our background tools, most important thing you should know is you will use our horizontal motor. When you see our Ringmaker machine, you will see one horizontal motor specially designed for background designs. That's our patented system. Many of the companies in the market do not use horizontal motor, but they use vertical motor for background finishing. Unfortunately, that's not enough for a good finishing, and it's not so useful. You have to spend more effort. In our Ringmaker CNC, you just put your tool, choose your model, write the size of ring, and start the operation. That's our biggest advantage with background designs, I can say. Now I will have a look at T4 Mini. That's also a popular tool. Some countries use this a lot because it gives a smooth finishing, and you can use even smallest items like tiny wedding bands and something. So let's have a look. That was a 3.5 millimeter head background tool that's commonly used for wedding bands. Again, if you want to get smooth surface, that's one of the tools you will need mostly. Here you can see on the ring the smooth and tiny lines. I will now try T4. That's our standard tool. That's the most selling one and most popular one. You will always need T4. So let's have a look how the result will be. Thank you. That was our most typical, traditional, classical, and most wanted tool, T4. That's really the most selling one and most popular one. Whatever you do, if you are using backgrounds, you will use you will need T4. Just keep in mind. So that was a. If I'm able to take it out, that was a. Wow, that was a fancy model. So if you are driving Lamborghini, if you are going to Bahamas, if you are wearing Rolex, you must use such fancy rings. By the way, so now let's see our next one, next ring. We are inside ring maker now. So here is the horizontal motor I tell you about. As you see, these traditional vertical motors, 1, 2, 3, and we have one more fourth motor for hammering in the newest version of Ringmaker. So despite these four vertical motors, we have one extra horizontal motor for the background design. Here you can see a background tool attached. So now let's have a look this new tool, T6 lining tool. There are small lines on this tool, so it will give much more smooth effect than the others. Let's try. I'm again inside Ringmaker. Just don't do that. If you have a Ringmaker, don't go inside. You have to stay outside. I'm just inside to make the videos now. Anyway, we just had a test on lining tool. Lining tool has the smoothest surface you will get. So if you need a smooth, fine finishing for your rings or even bangles, just go with lining tool. Here I will have a look at T12. That's a rough tool. You need a big surface such as bangles, big bangles for this. Let's see how the result will be. Another bangle. This background tool is pretty big, you can see here, so I recommend you to use with bangles only. So bangles, rings, whatever product you are using, you can send us one product, your picture, and we will recommend you the best option, which background tools you can use. So we are always waiting to hear from you. Let me tell you a little secret that's important for especially wedding band producers. You can, as I said, we have 300 different tools. You can combine each tool, and then you can combine the model, and then you can combine the spindle speed, and then you can combine the moving speed. So if you combine these four criteria, you will have a secret model for yourself. Nobody else can copy your background finishing except they know your values. So just write down these four criteria, these four numbers, write down in your records. So when you start making your ring, use these parameters. So that will be a unique model for your company, which is very important for keeping unique customers. That's our diamond plated background. There are real diamonds plated on this tool. So let's see how the result will be on bangles.
The
that was the diamond plated background tool. We worked on a bangle in this product. So diamond plated background tool is not engraving like the other carbide tools. That's just cleaning the surface and you get a shiny finishing. Here you can see on the bangle. I will try now the last tool, PCD vertical tool. Most important thing with this tool is you can use your vertical spindle. If you have a small CNC router or old style machine, you have no access to horizontal motor, you can still use this tool with your vertical motor. So let's try how the result will be. That was the only vertical background tool in this video which you watched. All the other tools were working horizontal, but this one was working vertical because of its shape. So if you have an old router or a different CNC machine without a horizontal motor, you can still work with this tool in your machine. That's a new tool. It's very popular in our among our products nowadays. The name is Ghost Tool because the effect is it's like an illusion, so that's why we call it Ghost Tool. So if you request something new, you should request us Ghost Tool. Thank you for watching Ghost Tool. Well, I'm Lord of the Rings now. So in this video, you watched our background tools, you learned more about how to use them. You can always contact us to ask more about our background tools. You can contact us via email info@bulunmaz.com, www.bulunmaz.com, our Facebook, Instagram, YouTube profiles. You can write us wherever you want. So we are waiting for you. We look forward to meet you. Thank you so much for watching us.